Rod Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Keith Waters' low comedy on the high seas. Edwards' Tug and Salvage. Starring Bob Crane. In the Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company and Lazy Boy Recliners. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Life, a little rain must fall. But for poor Bernard Edwards, it's a whole storm. Bernard is a perennial college student whose pranks are always thought of by others. But when they go astray, it's Bernard who takes the blame. In this little sea voyage we're about to take, our erstwhile hero has his hands full. There are some who take a life at sea. And there's Bernard, who gets sick over a glass of water. Why not join us now to revel in the fact that this story could only happen to somebody else?
This is not the dull days of summer, folks, because as this reporter stands here at Columbia University, a new world record is being set.
Honest,
the man behind this amazing feat is the captain's cut-up, Bernard Edwards. His brand new Ford Pinto car, and this is determined to be the first to get 32 human bodies jammed inside.
Not really.
And he may do it.
Oh, come on, fellas, you're going to get me in trouble.
Let's move
again.
Up closer and see if we can't get a word with Edwards. Oh, Mr. Edwards?
Yes?
Here, let me just get this microphone inside.
Hey, guys, a reporter.
Hey, what?
How
hey,
does it feel to be the first?
Yeah!
Come on, the long, hot summer.
Whoa, well, it's just an idea.
Yeah, great.
Hey, let's hear it from Bernie! That's the first station, KEZ. You heard it here. A great way to start off the summer. Right, Mr. Edwards?
Hey, Bernie, the dean wants to see you.
Edwards, what would you say to the dean of this great college? Will he expel you for this great
Dean Wanamaker, I'm sorry, sir. It was only a stunt. Lots of people enjoy it, and I know it's against regulations, but, sir, I didn't...
Shut up, Bernard. This telegram just came for you. Take it and get out of my office!
Oh. Who could be sending me a telegram? Mr. Bernard Edwards, it's my solemn duty to inform you that your grandfather, Sam Edwards, has passed away. Oh, poor grandpa. As your grandfather's lawyer, it was his wish that you be...
Sit down, Bernard. I'm not done.
Oh, yes, Mr. Horton. I'm sorry, sir.
As his sole heir, you have inherited his entire assets, which consists of the Edwards Tug and Salvage Company.
A bum tug.
Did you say something?
Well, I said poor granddad only had a broken-down tug, sir.
Yes, well, be that as it may, you are now the sole owner. Here's the key.
That's all? A key to the boat?
Tug.
Tug. Did he leave any instructions? I mean, I don't know a thing about tugging.
Oh, you don't. Right? Well, Bernard, my boy, perhaps as an old friend of the family.
You were? Gosh, I thought Grandpa hated you. I'm sorry, Mr. Horton.
Well, that was a long time ago. In any case, I'm sure that I could arrange for you to sell the tug.
Sell it? But I thought it wasn't worth much.
Well, of course it isn't, but I like your face, and I think I could get a nice price for you. Maybe even enough to cover the debts of that bum. I mean, your grandfather.
Gee, I don't know if he'd like that. I mean, I should at least look at
it. Oh, you must hurry. Well, I should say, think about it quickly.
Oh.
I don't know if the offer would stand too much longer.
Well, I'll certainly let you know, Mr. Horton. Where is the General Eisenhower Park?
Dr. Bernard. The tug is at Slip 5, Pier 11.
Hi, Lamplow. We're looking for somebody. Watch out!
That's not funny. Now, how else am I supposed to know the pier ended? To help me up, will you?
Okay, swim over to that ladder over there. To the left, dum-dum. Oh. That way's out to sea. Sorry.
If you hadn't scared me, I'm... see where I was going.
Boy, are you all wet. No offense, of course. I'm Alice Dunlop. What's your name, fat boy?
Bernard Edwards. Bernie to my friends.
Hi, Bernard. You all Sam's kin?
I am. I was looking for his boat. My boat, that is.
Here, this way.
Boy, is this my boat? Tug, hey, it's so terrific and
forget
clean.
It, Bernard. Yours is the next one over. This is my dad.
You mean that? That thing? I mean, it's half underwater.
Needs a little bilging for sure. Take your clothes off.
In front of you?
All right. Behind that screen is the head. In there.
Thank you. It's really nice of you, Miss Dunlop.
I know.
What was that?
Relax, dummy. A little Force 9 storm blowing up is all.
Bernard Edwards, you here?
Someone calling me?
Yeah, looks like someone's aboard your tug.
Edwards, where are you? I need you. Come out.
Oh, I better go see, huh? Here, over here. Next
here.
Door. What's that?
A pair of my dad's pants. You're in your shorts.
Oh, excuse me. I didn't...
Bernard Edwards, gotta see you right away.
Okay, just a second. I gotta get my pants.
Bernard, I'm an old friend of your grandpa's. You gotta help me.
Well, sure, if I can, sir.
I can't talk in front of her.
You can, too. If you need his help, you're gonna need mine, too.
All right, but could we get out of the rain?
Well, sure. Come on downstairs.
Below. The word for low, Bernard.
I'm sorry.
Bernard, I'm Roland Furlick. That mean anything to you?
Well, sure. Hi, Uncle Roly. I'm sorry, Mr. Furlick.
Yeah, that's all right. Thought you might remember. I used to bounce you on my knee.
Ha-ha, you sure couldn't do that anymore. Bernard, you gotta lose some weight.
I know. What's your problem, sir?
I'm about to lose my freighter.
I know. You're Furlick Freight Line.
Should be singular. Only got one. I've been pushing bananas between South America and here. But because of the oil shortage, I gotta load oil on board my ship.
Oh, there. It's gonna be all right.
Sure, Uncle Roly. Come on. What's wrong?
My good-for-nothing crew. First sign of a storm, they jump ship.
Well, that shouldn't be a problem, sir. I mean, get a new crew.
In the middle of the Gulf of Mexico.
Oh, holy cow.
In some other words. You see, under international salvage laws, the first tug to reach the vessel owns it.
Gosh.
Bernard, pay attention.
Oh.
Mr. Furlick, you want Bernard to go out and get your ship?
Please. He must. I can't trust anyone else to help me.
Well, I can't do that. I don't know anything
about it. That's the truth.
About running a tug, tugging a ship, whatever it is.
Well, I can help.
Yeah, me too. See, now you got a crew, Bernie.
Well, no, wait a minute.
Oh, please, it's my last chance or I'm wiped out.
Well, I'm not sure.
Well, do it. Uncle Roly, you got yourself a tug.
I hate it. Rain, darn stupid wet, eavesdropping, absolutely. I'm a lawyer, not a snoop. Oh, sorry, operator. Let me have ship to shore, operator. Okay, marine operator. No need to get snippy. It's not contagious. Marine operator, I need to talk to the tug Annie May. Whiskey Yankee Victor 4425, thank you. Clothes better get dry. Just put this on speakerphone.
Hello, calling party. I have your call. One moment, please. Hello, Annie May. Come in and go ahead.
This is March Toomey of the Annie May. Who is calling?
March, this is Horton. You were right. A dumb kid wouldn't sell. But there's something worse. Over.
Listen, I don't care about that now. Furlick has lost his ship. Idiot crew abandoned her, and we have a line on. I'll take care of the kid when we get in. Over and out.
Over and wait. March, that's what I'm trying to tell you. Furlick went to the kid, and I think he's going to try to take the Eisenhower out and try and help Furlick get the ship. Over.
Let him. We'll sink them. Then we can forget about the competition. Wait a minute. You think he's going to come out? What's that mean? Over.
I spied on him like you asked, and Alice Dunlop has taken a shine to the kid. She may try to help. Over.
That's trouble. But what do you mean, May? Over.
Last thing I saw, Tom Dunlop was driving his daughter off Edward's boat.
Never.
You know how he hated
any of the Edwards clan.
Dad, you let me go. I'm 21 and I'll do what I want.
No daughter of mine is going to give them good for nothing Edwards or finger.
Dad, you listen to me. Now you're always jumping on me to shine up to somebody.
Aye, but time you quit being a Tommy girl.
That's Tom girl and that's not what I am. I ain't. Now get out of my way.
You mean you like that short, four-eyed squirt?
Right. Not so loud, Dad. It'll scare him away.
Well, I'll be thundered. He never liked nobody except that squirrel in grade school. Well, go ahead. But you're gonna do it on your own.
Oh, Dad, you're a peach. I love you, Dad. Bye. Bernard! Salvage, wait for me.
What am I doing wrong? It feels like we're going in circles.
You are going in circles. Just keep the heading where I set it.
Oh, I don't feel so good.
My boy, I told you not to eat. But keep her headed across the trough so she won't grow.
Roach? You mean fall over? Oh, my.
Yeah, you could put it that way.
Oh, Rolly, I got some bad news. That bum March Toomey has somehow got out there and thrown a line on your ship.
Bum! He was always a no-good bum.
Help!
A bum.
Oh, Bernard, you're so clutchy.
I'm sorry.
Give me that wheel. Sluggish, Bernard. You're going to have to work on this old tub when we get back in. In fact, you're going to have to work on your old tub, too.
I see her. I see her off the port. Come about.
Come about what?
Oh, Bernard. Yeah, I see her about 1,000 yards.
My ship. What's going to happen to my ship?
Oh, we ain't licked yet, Rolly.
We ain't? Aren't?
Nope. The Annie Mae's only got a single toe in this weather. It could snap. Ah, Toomey never was much of a seaman. Stand by. I'm going to run this old tug at full throttle.
Oh, my gosh. Now what?
Bernard, get the radio.
Which?
The one on the left. Flip it to receive.
Alice, they lost it. They lost their tow line.
Hello? Who's there?
This is the Annie Mae calling to General Eisenhower. Over.
Over.
Answer them, Bernie.
Oh.
Oh, no, never mind.
Oh.
Here, take the wheel.
All right. Oh, good grief, I got it. Do I drive straight ahead?
10 degrees to starboard.
Yes, okay.
Annie Mae, this is the General Ike. What do you want, you pirates?
Oh, come on, Alice. This is March Toomey. How can you talk to an old friend like that?
It's easy, you son of a...
Alice!
Sea turtle. Look, you lost your toe, so scoot. We got Furlick on board, and it's his ship.
Forget it, honey, man. That ship is remounted to any man who gets her, and I'm going to get her.
Not if we get there first, you won't.
Let me warn you, Dunlop, that ship is worth $1 billion to me, and I ain't to get it.
Oh, how am I doing?
Terrific! If we were going to Greenland, spin that wheel!
Oh, I'm sorry.
Roland, we gotta blast the line on board your ship, and somebody's got to secure it and feed it back. You want to handle the wheel?
I'm a little rusty, but I'll try.
Look, if you're rusty, Bernard here is rusted shut. Okay, work is close on.
Alice, is that a tug supposed to be heading toward us?
What? God, holy catfish!
See?
Swing, Bernie! Oh, swing the port! No, port!
Oh,
you
I'm
metal
sorry.
Train! Watch out, everybody!
This I know of. I took engineering in college. Take that canvas over there and stuff it around the hole. I'll help pull these crates over.
Okay, genius. Now what?
These crates here. Yeah, that should hold. Now, the ocean doesn't get rougher.
Don't think so. The storm center's passed.
Come on, let's get back on deck. What was that?
I think the Annie Mae's trying to drop a line across the ship. Hey, looky there.
Yeah, a freighter. A ship, it'll crush us.
Pretty good, huh?
Great, Rolly. Bernie, up front, come on. See, this is a harpoon gun, only it will toss a grapple across the ship with a rope.
Yeah, I guess I see.
Hold your ears.
Superior, first time, how'd you do that?
First in my class in archery.
Wow.
Roland, we got it.
Yeah. I'm moving you in now to board.
Board? We're actually going to get on the freighter?
Sure, we have to secure our tow.
Ahoy, the Eisenhower! Cut that line or we will ram you again.
Rolly, hand me that loud hail.
Here.
Thanks.
Ahoy, the enemy! We have line for tow. If you interfere, it is a violation of the international law.
That is our prize, Eisenhower. You will stand clear.
Up your mast. Annie Mae. Come on, Bernie. We got work to do.
Look, Alice, when the bums abandoned my ship, they left the gangplank hanging. With the sea down, I think I can get us close enough to grab it.
Worth a try, Rolly. Do it. Bernie, haul in the tow line.
Got it.
Rolly, we may do it yet.
Yeah, if those bums don't try something else.
Bernie, watch out the line. The Annie Mae's trying to cut it.
We may miss this.
They missed the rope, Alice.
Keep hauling it in as we get closer, or we'll foul her over. sound props. Rolly, I wonder why they didn't board earlier.
Sea was running too high. Here they come again. Now will you look at that? They are trying to get to the gangplank before us.
Boy, that's all we need is some other creeps trying to horn in.
Ahoy! A man, boy! You'll stand up from the prize. This is the Royal Flush. Ahoy, Amime. Do you hear?
That's Daddy. Great jumping jelly beans, Daddy.
To the rescue. I'm proud of old Tom Dunlop.
Alice, the Amime is turning around. They're leaving.
Yeah, I see.
That was some meal, Mr. Dunlop.
Aye, why not have a fourth helping?
Come on, Dad, you're not all that tough. Be nice to Bernie.
Okay. You're welcome, Bernard.
Bernie, sir.
Bernard.
Yes, sir. Anyway, I am grateful for the meal and your assistance today.
Weren't nothing. Says got to thinking couldn't let me own daughter alone. I didn't know what kind of a rascal you might be.
Well, we'll get him shaped up, Dad. Won't we, Bernie?
Yeah, well,
I'll get it. Everyone, look who it is.
Rolly, hi.
Mr. Farlick, please, a seat.
I only came to stay a moment. Bernie, this is for you.
A check? For $5,000?
Yeah, couldn't afford much more, all the debts I got. But it should help you put the eye back in shape.
I don't know what to say.
I do. A toast to a long and happy life for the General Eisenhower and her crew.
Crew?
Yeah, us.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
Edwards' Tug and Salvage is an original radio drama by Keith Walker. Bob Crane was heard as Bernard Edwards. Featured in the cast were Ruby Person, Les Tremaine, Luke Krugman, Jack Edwards, and Dick Van Patten. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Collis, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions, Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman, Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.